Everyone, this is Russ Adams on Rosstv, coming to you freaking live on Rosstv Studios and YouTube. Oh man, I got a lot of things to say for this week's episode. Well, the first thing I wanted to get off my chest, how about the Red Sox? Are you kidding me? Are they going to go really fall for this? Oh, they're gonna choke! They're gonna choke! Oh, no! They're gonna choke! Oh! Fuck you! They're just making it dramatic. The Red Sox got it. They're facing the Bowie Bay Sox, for Christ's sake. I think they can beat the Bowie Bay Sox, you know? I'm referring to the Baltimore Orioles, if you guys don't know who the Bowie Bay Sox are. They are a double-A franchise! They're terrible! They have no pitching, and they got Chris Giacobacchus pitching, for Christ's sake. Who the fuck is he? I mean, like, fuck! Red Sox make it. They're not going very far, though, but they're going to make it. Tampa Bay don't have enough. They don't have enough hitting. They have enough pitch to beat Boston. If Tampa Bay wasn't so stupid to get rid of Crawford and, like, Pena and shit, they would win the East again. Oh, yeah, they're not the Yankees. They don't have all that money. But they should have got rid of B.J. Upton when they had a chance. Get another piece in there. Get another bat. Put Jennings in center field. But no. Tampa Bay just fucks up again. Oh, Christ. Their general manager's a good guy. He knows what he's doing. I don't know about this one. As for the wild card, I don't think the Angels, not enough of the wild card. But I wouldn't be surprised if they beat the Rangers head-to-head if they can get it within three games. I would not be surprised if the Angels beat the Rangers. The Rangers, they're big shit. They're really not that great. Their hitting's awesome. I would take their hitting any day in the week. Their pitching, maybe it's low pitch softball, maybe. I don't know, but no. No chance. They got lucky last year. My team this year in the American League to make it to the World Series would have to be, I'm sorry, it's the Yankees. Even though their pitching's not that great either. How in the hell can you say no to Curtis Granderson? Jesus Christ, that boy could hit. Fuck A-Rod, he's a little bastard. But fuck, that team could hit. Nova, oh. Mariano, oh. Sick, CC, AJ Burnett's going to be the reason why they don't win the World Series, if they don't win it. In the National League, it looks like the Braves got the wild card wrapped up, but St. Louis and the Giants are making a little run, but the Giants' 8-game win streak was snapped last night by Clayton Kershaw. No way he should win the Cy Young. You know why he should win the Cy Young? You need to be a fucking playoff team to be a Cy Young winner. I'm sorry. It ain't happening. Nope. They give him the Cy Young, I will bitch like hell on my next episode. Ian Kennedy should be this NL Cy Young. Won 20 games this year. Took a team last year was literally shit. Piece of shit. And look, they're about to win the division. Arizona Diamondbacks. That's the fucking team. That's the fucking player. Who should get it? Cliff Lee just put himself out of the running last night because the Nationals whipped that ass. They whipped that ass all night long. And if Roy Halladay was out there, we'd whip his ass too. Phillies. Oh, fuck the Phillies. They're a joke. The backup player is Michael Martinez. Get the fuck out of here. Get that Michael Martinez shit out of here. We got to see what their Phillies bench looked like yesterday. Ooh. Man, you better hope Chase Elliott don't get hurt. We don't want to see Wilson Valdez at second. But, Phillies are one-dimensional, I think. And you know what's even funnier? The Nationals, they make fun of the Nationals a lot. Nationals are almost five games under 500. We could be in the race if we don't have fucking John Lannon and Todd Caulfield on the fucking team and Doug Slayton. We don't have those three guys on the team. This team is easily over 500. We had Ryan Zimmerman. If we had Ryan Zimmerman for those 40 games that he missed, and Jason Worth was hitting at all, just think about it, boys. We could be in the wild card chase, and we're also 8-8 against the Phillies this year. Don't call me a jackass, but I think the Nationals got him next year. But we got some good young talent. Like Espinoza, Morse, Strasburg, Desmond, Bernardina, Peacock, Malone. I can keep going. Storen's one of the best closers in the league, if not the best, behind Mariano Rivera, of course. That's why I call Storen Mariano Rivera Jr. And there's another nice little stat. Nationals Park is a pitcher's park. Citizens Bank Paul Park is a hitter's park. Nationals have one less home run than the Phillies. You look it up. You look that shit up. We have one less home run than the Phillies this season. Yippers. I know I might like look crazy, but the Nationals are close to the Phillies. Even though we're 26 back, we may not sound like we're close, but we're really close. We had Ryan Zimmerman for 40 games. Oh, Christ. I don't know what we would do. Oh. But back to the college football. You know what really pisses me off? Why switch conferences so much? We know it's for money, yeah, but do I really want to see a Pittsburgh-North Carolina game or Pittsburgh-Duke? Syracuse versus Wilmy Tech? I don't want to see that shit. Just keep it the way it is, you know? Basketball. I don't want to see Syracuse and, like, Clemson. I want to see that shit. Syracuse and Clemson? Blow me. And then they want Texas to go to the Pac-12. Get the hell out of here. They would rape that fucking place. They rape the Big 12 as it is. Even with a third string backup right now. That's why Colorado and Nebraska left. So they don't have to face Texas no more. Oklahoma wants to leave, I think. I don't know. I don't even know what they want to do. One minute they want to leave, next minute they don't want to leave. Make your fucking mind up. The Big East is pretty much dead. And I need some moon mist. It's pretty good. If you don't like it, then you're a faggo. One of my wonderful sponsors, unofficially. That was your Fago Moon Mist break of the night. But they need to stop moving so many effing teams. If you're going to move anybody, move Notre Dame. Put them in the toilet. You know, they're no good. They're losing to South Florida nowadays. Like, give me a break. But, NFL, how about the Carolina Panthers? They're probably the best 0-2 team in the league right now. Cam Newton is whipping that ass everywhere. Oh, he is the man. He has nobody else to throw to besides Steve Smith. Throwing 430 yards a game. I'm loving it. I'm not even a Panthers fan, but I love Cam Newton. I might be kissing his ass a little bit. Yeah, but whatever. I love Cam Newton. He should be on the Broncos. Get rid of Tim Tebow's candy ass. We should have tanked it last year. One more spot. Von Miller's a nice pickup. I'll take it. We should have got Cam Newton. I'm so stupid. God damn it. I should have rooted for them to lose all their games. Now we have to have fucking Tim Tebow. Christ. But in other news, I want to give you guys my NFL picks for this week. I'm going to give you my pick of the week. I didn't give you a pick last week because I was too busy getting my groove on at Temple U, drinking up with the kiddies, hanging out with the bros and hoes. And no, they're not really hoes. They're awesome. They're good. They're good gals. Their boyfriends are the shit. You know who I'm talking to. Yep. And hopefully we can make you guys a winner this week. Alright, I'm going to give you guys an upset of the week this week. And I'll try to give you guys one every week. And there's some good matchups in here. Like Washington, Dallas, Pittsburgh, Indianapolis, Atlanta, Tampa Bay, Green Bay, Chicago. That's not bad. Giants, Eagles, Houston, New Orleans. You know what? I'm going to give you an upset this week that you guys can pee your pants on. Take Houston and the points at New Orleans on Sunday. Watch it. Houston may win that game. I'm giving it to you right now. Houston over New Orleans. You're going to pee your pants. Or your panties if you're a girl. But that is the game to watch, I think. Fuck that Detroit, Minnesota, New England, Buffalo. Buffalo ain't upsetting New England. New England's going to whip that ass all over Ralph Wilson Stadium. And Ralph Wilson will be begging the Buffalo Bills fans to stay. Not happening. Get the fuck out of town. It's a joke. But it's cool. Shit happens, you know.
Need help keeping your
day. Yep. Oh, what else was I gonna say? West York beat Spring Grove again. Whip that ass. West York's the type of team I don't know what direction they're going in right now. It could be Central York. I don't understand that. Central York is like Central York's like the gum on my sock. You know? Gummer Mifflin I thought was good. Spring Grove, I knew they were terrible, but I feel bad for Russell Stoner. He's working with kids that rather pick corn, you know? Shit happens. It's a shame. But, West York plays Dallas Town this week. West York is going to whip that at Dallas Town ass all over the fucking county. Whip that ass. It'll be a mercy rule. They'll be begging for mercy. But, that is all for Rosstv this week. And I'll try to make some more episodes. I want to give a shout out to my boy Ben Saladay. Or Saladay. I just wanted to sound silly. Andy Shelley, Bucky Kinney, Lauren Gensler, Carly Ness, and we throw Gibbs in there, why not? Hell yeah, I'll give Gibbs a shout out. I hope he doesn't bite my nuts again. No, I'm just kidding. And Gary Wirt, what's going on? And anybody else that watches the show. This is Russ Adams on Rosstv. I'm getting out of here. I gotta get my drink on. I have bitches in my room. Nah, I'm just kidding. I do have drinks available, though. See ya, folks.